Hello, my most amazing and awesome artists. Today we're continuing on our alphabet soups. We are going to be painting that soup and filling our bowl today. You need to make sure that your name is on the back as well as hidden in your bowl of alphabet soup. By hidden, I mean with oil pastels, with different colors, and maybe a little jumbled, but so that you could still read it if you looked. We're going to be using watercolor paints today, which means you need water to make them color. So first I dip in the water. If it starts to drip, wipe it on the lip, and then I dance around into that watercolor tray. I make sure that my brush is staying on its tippy toes, never ever scooting around on its bottom, because nobody wants to go to the booty scooting ballet. Make sure that your paintbrush stays like a ballerina on its tippy toes. Never ever smash it down, especially because today, if you smash down your paintbrush, Miss Q will know, because your letters will start to smear. That oil pastel is very fragile, meaning that it could smear if you press down too hard. Also, make sure you have your hands or your fingers not in the danger zone, never on the hairs, but on that comfy pillow for your fingers. Make sure that you keep the paintbrush dancing on the tippy toes and never scooting around on the bottom because, like I said, your letters will start to smear. If they start to smear, your bowl will become a bowl of mashed alphabet soup, and we don't want to not be able to see all that hard work you did on your letters. So after you finish your soup, or maybe I start with yellow, then I go into a little bit of orange. Now, I'm switching my color to give it more of a realistic look. My soup is more of like a chicken noodle soup or a vegetable broth, whatever kind you want, but warm colors only. There are not any soups that we're making today that are using the cool colors. So there's a space in between on your watercolor tray. Make sure you're only using the warm colors, kind of like hot or fire colors, red, orange, and yellow. Those are the colors that will make a nice, realistic soup color for our alphabet soup. Every time I mix a color, though, I wash my brush. If I start to notice that my lines are scratchy, that means my paintbrush is thirsty. He needs water. So if I notice that my lines are getting scratchy or that my letters are getting smeary, that means I need a lot more water to be able to dance right over them to do that wax resist. Remember that we're able to see the oil pastel because it's saying, "Get off me, paint," and pushing that paint right off. That would not happen if you use too much or press down too hard. Then you will cover your oil pastel, and that's not what we want to do today. So I'm mixing a little bit of orange into mostly yellow. I don't think I use any red today, but if you would like a darker soup, you could. After that, I'm going to use two hands and bring it to the drying rack like a pizza, holding it flat so that it doesn't drip, like it's the most important pizza I've ever delivered. After my soup bowl is on the drying rack, I'm going to pick up a big piece of paper that already has a circle drawn out for it. After I pick out that paper and bring it back to my table, I'm going to write my name and class code on the back of it in pencil. Super important. Then we're going to be making a plaid pattern. A plaid pattern is kind of like crisscrossing lines. Sometimes you see it on shirts or on tablecloths. We're using neon oil pastels to do this. You need to press pretty hard with those oil pastels when you're making your lines. To start out with my plaid pattern, I am making vertical lines, meaning going straight up and down. Once I get to my plate, I'm going to have to jump over it. Now, this is going to be used as the bowl that we put our soup into. So we want to make sure it stays really clean by jumping right over it. If you draw through it, that's going to matter when we glue our soup into that bowl. So make sure you jump right over, pretending that your lines would continue right underneath that bowl or plate, just as if you placed it over top. It's kind of a little trick or an optical illusion. It tricks your eye into thinking there's a plate there. Then I'm going to do the same thing, but horizontally with another color. I pick another color and make horizontal lines. When I get to that plate, I jump right over it and continue on the other side, just like it went right underneath that bowl. So I continue my lines pressing hard with my other color. I decided on using two colors today. I would highly suggest that you only choose two or three colors for your plaid pattern. You could even just choose one if you wanted to. Usually a plaid or checkerboard pattern has two colors. So I'm choosing these colors and spacing my lines out in different ways. If you notice my green lines, I have a pattern of two lines, a space, two lines, a space, two lines. With my pink, I'm making horizontal lines. I'm just making those stripes the same distance apart, making sure to keep my plate very clean. I can do that by turning my paper as I work, making sure my wrists aren't dragging across my paper, and I want to make sure I finish that pattern and put away my pastels and make sure my hands are clean. If I've got dirty hands and accidentally lean my hand up on my plate, I'm going to get a dirty plate and that will not be able to be erased. Once I'm done with my oil pastels, I put them aside and choose one color, any color in my watercolor tray. For the soup, we were only able to use the warm colors. But now, if you want to use the cool colors, you absolutely can. But I would suggest choosing one of those colors, using a lot of water, dancing around in that watercolor paint, and painting in your tablecloth or your placemat. When I'm painting, keeping a ballerina on its tippy toes, but making sure if my paintbrush is thirsty, I give it a lot of water because we're making a wax resist. That oil pastel is pushing off the paint and saying, "Get off me, paint," which is why you need a lot of water so that it dances right on over top of the oil pastel and you can see your lines. Be super careful around the plate. This is where I would start to really take your time and move your paintbrush slowly around that edge of that bowl, being very careful not to get any paint inside the bowl. I'm doing my best and painting all around, making sure I get all white spaces except for that bowl. That is the only white space that should be left on my paper. Again, if I press down too hard, I am going to end up with a big mess of smeared oil pastel. But if I keep my paintbrush on its tippy toes, it will dance right over top and show that awesome magic trick of that wax resist technique. When I'm done with my painting, it's super important that I clean my brush, put it back, and then take two hands and bring this to the drying rack so carefully. This is a big piece of paper and it could easily drop or fold. So I'm holding it very flat so that it doesn't drip or spill and taking it to the drying rack. Then I'm going to clean my hands and area, paintbrush, and make sure my paint tray is clean as well. And then I'm good to go until next week when it's dry. Your hands and area are clean and your paintbrush is already in that bowl setting out to dry, then you are good to go. All right, artists, have fun today.